We are studying transformer today. Transformer is a device which is used maximum in alternating current. The work of transformer is to increase or decrease the voltage, and that can be done only in AC, as you will study. It can increase or decrease the EMF of AC supply. It cannot increase or decrease the EMF of a DC supply. In fact, for DC supply, we cannot change the EMF once it is generated. And that is the problem with DC, and that is why AC has become successful all over the world, because its voltage can be increased or decreased. And we will see in the next lectures to come how we use this phenomena of increasing or decreasing the voltage of AC for its transmission. And that increase and decrease of voltage is done by transformer. So the transformer is very, very important, and without this we cannot distribute electricity all over the country. So now let us see what is the introduction. Is what I have told you, it is a device which can change potential difference and current of AC supply. Okay, required for transmission. Now, on what principle of physics it works? This works on the principle of mutual induction. Okay, when working, we will come to know. Description, the parts. One is soft iron core. This is soft iron core. That means, core means a frame on which we will make the transformer. So we have to take a frame like this. This is for the purpose of our study. In principle, we use this type of core. This is a frame. This is also a frame, but there is a middle arm in this. In this, we are having two windings on one side, on the other side. Practically, we are using this arm as a common arm, and in this we are having these two windings here, primary, and over that primary we make this secondary. So for study purpose, both are same, working is same. This is what we are doing in practice. Okay, so this is a copper wire, a pure copper wire, and this is secondary winding, and one is known as primary winding. We can change with each other, no problem. We can always reverse it. Now, soft iron, copper. Working, how does it work? On the basis of mutual induction. What happens? We supply here alternating EMF. Alternating EMF whose voltage keeps on changing direction, its magnitude change continuously, and this current in this soft iron core in make a magnetic field. And we know the magnetic field in solenoid is mu naught and I. Yes. Due to current and the winding, it makes a magnetic field. Now this magnetic field, which is generated here, cannot go out, does not go out, because soft iron has got a very large susceptibility. It does not allow magnetic field to go out. So if the magnetic comes out from here like this, then it goes here, continuous line, it goes here, then it goes here, and it goes here, here. So this is a continuous loop, this is second loop, this is third loop, this is fourth loop, and thousands of loops, millions of loops can be made here, but this flux will not go out because of the ferromagnetic nature of the soft iron. Okay, so this magnetic field touches this coil. Area of the coil when touched by magnetic field creates a magnetic flux. So magnetic flux is created here. Now this I is a alternating current, and this is I naught sine omega t, and its nature is this way. So it keeps on changing. If this is changing according to omega, then B is changing, and when B changes, then flux here, flux is what? Flux is B into A. So if B is changing, the flux is also changing. And when the flux changes here, then changing of flux create what? EMF. So an EMF is created across this coil of which the flux is being changed. This way EMF is created here. This is mutual induction, what we have been studying in EMI also. So this way we get an EMF here. This is how it works. We supply EMF in primary, we get EMF in secondary. This is how it works. See, the changing current in primary create changing magnetic field, then the flux linked to secondary is also keeps on changing, and this changing flux create induced EMF. Okay, this number one, number two, number three. This EMF is created, which we use as secondary potential difference. So this is how a transformer works. Now how do we change the EMF? See, that is the basic working of the transformer. How EMF change? Calculation of voltage change or calculation of EMF change? We know every time there is a magnetic field here, and because of that magnetic field there is a flux here, and this flux keeps on changing. The flux, the field, this is common for both the coils. So when there is a magnetic field, its value here, 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 everywhere magnetic field is same. Now area of cross section of this coil is same. If A is same, if B is same, then phi is also same for any one term. Now if there is a change due to AC, there is a change in magnetic flux, and that change of magnetic flux is also same, whether it is this term or it is this term. That change of magnetic flux can be written as d phi by dt. So I start from here. Let d phi by dt be the change of flux. Change, or I should say rate of change. D phi by dt be the rate of change of flux. Then EMF induced in secondary. EMF induced in secondary in one coil, it is d phi by dt. But there is not one coil. There are large number of coils, and let us say these number of coils are number of turns in secondary, and here number of turns in primary. So in secondary, how much EMF is, total EMF is there? Here it is d phi by dt, 2d phi by dt, 3, 4, 5, 6, ns. So this is ns times d phi by dt. This is EMF across secondary. How much is the EMF across primary? EMF across primary at any moment is np d phi by dt. So at any instant, when there is a rate of change of d phi by dt across secondary, we see this much, and across primary we see this much EMF. Okay, now let's divide the two. If we divide the two, we find that EMF across secondary upon EMF across primary is equal to, here minus minus cancel, d phi by dt cancel, and what we get is ns upon n, transformer ratio or transformation ratio. So in this we see that ns NPESEP. EMF across secondary, potential difference across secondary is equal to NS times NP multiplied by EMF across primary. Now, if NS is larger than NP, ES we will receive larger than EP. If NS is less than NP, then ES we will get less than EP. That means voltage in the secondary may be larger or may be smaller than voltage across the primary. That means there may be two types of transformer in which the voltage from secondary will be higher than voltage in primary, and in other type of transformers voltage through the secondary will be lesser, smaller than the voltage across primary. Now we have bifurcated this as the transformer of two types, one is step up and one is step down. Now we can write it, what is step up and what is step down. In step up transformer, EMF output, that is secondary, is larger than E input. This means number of turns in secondary is higher than number of turns in primary. That means NS upon NP is larger than 1. Then it is a step up transformer, so output voltage higher. So whenever we use a transformer in which output voltage we want higher one, then which transformer is required? Answer, step up transformer is required. Now let us see step down transformer. In step down, NS upon NP is less than 1. That means number of turns in secondary are less than number of turns in primary. In this, if this is like this, this is larger, this is smaller. So EMF in secondary will be less than EMF in primary. So this is to decrease the voltage, and we need both of them. For transmission from powerhouse, if we are producing at 220 volt and we want to supply at 22,000 volt, then which transformer we will use? Answer, we will use step up transformer. In my house there is a 220 volt supply and I want to charge my mobile which work at 4 volt or 5 volt, then what type of transformer will I use? Answer, I will use step down transformer. So this way both of these processes are our requirement. Therefore we need both type of transformers, step up as well as step down. So this is transformation of voltage through a transformer. Okay, then what happens to electric current? Does it increase, does it decrease, or is there no action? Answer is, there is an action. The current also decrease or increase. Now we will study how the current will increase or how the current will decrease, and that we will see in the next lecture, along with other phenomena of the transformer, that is what are the losses of energy in a transformer and what are applications of transformer. So that we will see in the next lecture. Thank you.